Today, the ever-growing supermarkets and superstores sell everything.
We're selling clothes, we're selling insurance, we're selling petrol.
You can pick up everything you want in one place.
It's convenient, it's just easy.
But our love affair with the big boys is killing Britain's small shops.
We're sacrificing our greengrocers, our bakers, our high streets, our communities for convenience. We'll miss our neighbourhood shops when they're gone. And I don't want to live in a Britain that bland.
I made my name in luxury and fashion retail. But now I'm heading into a whole new world to work out a survival plan for our local shops. This week, I set out to fix a broken DIY store.
I actually don't know what I'm going to find behind these doors, you know?
My house is on the line. If this doesn't go, I'll be more than screwed.
But the owner seems to have a screw loose.
I'm not a salesman. I can't go around knocking on doors.
You are a salesman, Tony. That's what this business is, mate.
I'm absolutely gobsmacked that nothing's been done. Nothing.
They've forgotten the nuts and bolts of their business.
What is that? Who uses those, Tony? I mean, I bet you those are going out by the truckload, not.
And I've got just 6 weeks to try and hammer in some sense.
You don't agree with me, really?
No, I don't.
Well, that's fantastic, because I've got a day to go.
I don't know, it's maybe it's a love-hate relationship. She loves her and I love me and we hate each other, so it might be that way.
This week, I'm heading to the town of Lightwater in Surrey to see a struggling DIY store.
I remember I had this fantastic little DIY shop that was around the corner from me, and they were so handy because the guy knew everything. And they closed down. And I felt at quite a loss since that I haven't got anybody who has that knowledge and would be able to advise me. So I'm going to be going into the shop, first of all, thinking from my point of view, because I've got to be the worst person possible to be doing DIY.
An Englishman's home is his castle, and leafy suburban Lightwater is full of the house proud.
I reckon this is the sort of place that, you know, Doug would do his own DIY at home. Doug, we've got a problem. Don't worry, Beryl. Just get my toolkit out. I can kind of feel that here.
So the local DIY store should be raking it in.
Lightwater Homecare.
Tony Leach has worked in the building trade his whole life and took over this store 12 years ago.
I bought this shop because I knew a little bit about the trade, and we used to do decorating and painting and general DIY work. That didn't seem a good idea.
But within no time, Tony decided to expand on his range.
This is a very unique shop. We're not just a DIY hardware store.
Rabbits, guinea pigs, birthday cards, helium balloons. The list goes on. 15,000 lines.
And as that range has grown...
Yeah, well, the secret with this stuff is don't put too much on.
Tony's taken on a lot of staff without a DIY background.
I didn't want to work in a DIY shop. It's just that I actually applied for the job and got the job.
But this vast, sprawling store isn't making money.
That's 10p, please.
The average customer comes in for loose ends and spends less than a fiver.
I don't quite know what to use.
It's so soul-destroying. You walk in here and say, I just bought this from B&Q. Can you do so-and-so? They will always use us to soundbite what they want to do. So many people don't come in here first.
It's a far cry from his 80s heyday when his office fitting company was making millions.
The way things are going at the moment, I think we've got probably a 2 to 3 year life. If I go bankrupt, I lose my house, I lose everything, and I'll be out on the street.
So your local home care store, the one-stop shop for all your home care needs. What is that window? It looks like someone spewed up on the window. And look at the notice board. Can you read anything behind that? Oh, we've also got a shoe repair independent craftsman in here. I actually don't know what I'm going to find behind these doors, you know?
A DIY store has to look well maintained, and I'm losing faith before I've even crossed the threshold.
Hello.
Hiya.
Hi.
Who are you?
Henry.
Henry, hi, I'm Mary.
Nice to meet you.
And you're?
Hi, I'm Jane.
Jane.
Hi.
Where's Tony, the owner?
He's in the office.
All right, don't go yet, because I need your help.
Yeah.
Right, he'll be able to advise you. Right,
for okay. a DIY amateur like me, hardware stores has to be about quality advice. So, I'm going to test them out.
I have a problem at home where I need to have some internal locks on my doors because some Muppets nicked my son's bike, climbed over the fence. What sort of thing should I be looking for?
Well, I can show you the locks and... We've got all the indoor locks here.
OK. But that's a front door one, isn't it? Isn't that a front door lock?
Oh, that's an external one. Let's have a look down here. Let's have a look. I'm not that...
You're not that...
That good
at locks.
The locks and that, no.
So you're probably not the best person. Blind leading the blind.
I won't be solving my lock problem here, then. But there's an awful lot of other problems staring me in the face. Time to go fill my basket.
Why would you? Why? Oh, for Christ's sake.
This is the front of your store, OK? This is where really good, important purchases are made. Why would you take it up with the dog calendars? Would you come in here and see Henry and Jane for your hair tongs? Poinsettia soap dish. Oh, look at the window blind. I think I'm going to need a bigger basket at this place. Do you think he's put these things out just to catch me out? Why would I have my safety footwear next to the multi-purpose household towels? It's dangerous in that kitchen, let me tell you. What is that? This place just goes on and on and on.
Oh, and I'm in a toy shop. Why has he done this? It's chance at retailing. Oh, I'll just chance putting that in, because if they walk by, they might just find something.
And at the back, it's the Lightwater Town Zoo.
What are you doing in here? Along with the kitchen accessories in the DIY department. It does feel like it could be a pound shop. This is how not to do it, actually. I wonder what he genuinely thinks about this place. Hi, Tony.
Hi.
So you're the man who owns this store?
I am indeed.
Forget this is your business. Honestly, guess what shop I've been in? So I've got a metal newspaper holder. A poodle calendar, and yes. That. Who uses those, Tony? I mean, I bet you those are going out by the truckload. Not.
No, I sold three of them.
And you're responsible for that disgusting soap dish.
No, I wasn't, actually.
Yes, you were. And I've got some old bird's comfort shoe. We've got to decide whether we want to make this a general store or we actually want to make it a brilliant DIY store.
I prefer the DIY store.
I bet you would. What is your vision?
I just think to have... the stock that the people require in this village, basically, to have what they need. It does mostly does turn.
Well, what's your best sellers then? In this shop, what's your best sellers?
We've got 15,000 lines in here, you see.
I think you're a little bit scared to go, right, we're going to chase that market. Right, I'm going to stand for this, and we are going to be the best at this.
Everything we do in here, we do get asked for at some point in time.
So someone's come in and said, Tony, could you get me some shoes, some old bird? Mm. Oh, stop it.
Honestly. Mary's very good in fashion retailing, but this is completely different. Until she actually comes up with, you should be doing X, Y, Z, whether I agree or don't agree, that's the next step. Knowing me, I probably won't, but there again, we'll try anything once.
I'm beginning to think that Tony might be part of the problem. So I'm going to see what his staff think.
Hello. Jane and Henry.
Hello.
What does Tony do?
Well, he does...
Why are you laughing, Henry?
Nothing.
He does the accounts and...
Is Tony a good boss? Oh, look at her face. What's your face?
Well, he can be miserable.
Can he?
Yeah.
No comment.
Do you buy the stuff, like the house, home accessories, the blinds?
Yeah, I do.
Do you buy the rabbits from here as well?
I've had a rabbit and guinea pig from the shop.
What are they called?
I haven't got them anymore. They got eaten by the rabbit's fox. That was the day I went to the pub with these lot.
I haven't got a clue what to make of that. Tony's hiding up in the office doing the accounts, which we all know are kind of basically nil, and he's got a bunch of quite mad, zany people working in there who are just sort of like, you know, getting on with whatever he happens to buy, they'll try and sell. It's mad. It's mad.
Spending on DIY has gone up over 50% in the last decade, but mostly at the big superstores and warehouses. But for me, DIY is a whole new world, so I think it'll be really helpful to check out Tony's competition. Tony's nearest rival is only 6 miles away, so a couple of days later, I drag him over there.
Step one. As they say in those wonderful ads, it says what it does on the tin. I look up there, focus, DIY and gardening. Simple. I look at the front of your shop, I've got balloons, I've got a doorway that's got more notices on it. The clearness is here is we are a DIY business. But I look at your business and I'd be hard-pressed to know exactly what it does. Come on, come on. OK. Right, we'll start at the front. First of all, I have wonderful space. I can breathe, you know? What have I got in your front? There were baskets clambering over, broken ones, holes in them, some baskets for sale. Jane was in the corner unloading. Already, I can go, right, OK, where do I need to go? Right, there's my gardening section, there's my decorating, there's my lighting, tiles and flooring. It's all laid out very simply. Very simply, and I, as a shopper, already think, OK, yeah, I know where to go.
You look at the space, it's not filled. They could double their stock in here. Look at the empty space there. Do you want to walk around the shop? What you're doing is walking around an empty shop, basically. Our shop is stacked full of stuff.
So we're barely through the door before our first disagreement.
There's so much empty space here. And who's paying for the space? You're paying for the space when you walk in the door and buying their stuff.
OK. You think that? I actually think it looks quite nice. I quite like a bit of space.
Being well signposted and spacious is exactly what attracts customers. It's so much easier to shop.
If I'm a customer and I'm standing in here, this feels confident, it feels sophisticated, it feels professional. Ours feels like, you know, the old curiosity shop at times. That is the truth, and it's kind of fun, but it isn't making us enough money.
See, my argument to that is that we sell everything. Everything you see in there, 99% of it, 95% of it, we sell.
But you don't sell enough of.
No.
That's the problem.
You don't think our departments are departmentalised enough?
No, not at all. I need to look at that and see how we segment that and clearly delineate the areas. And then it's deciding what those areas are going to be.
Yeah.
I know you're not with me on this.
I am.
No, I am. Oh, you are?
I'm getting
okay.
There.
But I'm going to have to do more than reorganise the store to convince Lightwater to shop local.
It's not like going to a great baker's or a great butcher's and going, we get, you know, local, organic meat, taste the difference. We can't compete on value, taste. I can't do that. A pot of paint is a pot of paint. So where do you compete? But it's a really difficult task, you know?
Tony claims to give locals everything they could ever dream of. But strangely, I don't think he's ever stopped to work out their DIY needs. So this morning, I'm taking him out of that back office to come face to face with some suburban DIYers.
Morning, 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 locals of Lightwater. I'm sorry it's cold in here. Have we all got your cups of tea and biscuits? I've left biscuits there for you to dunk if you want them, so do feel that you can. Do any of you use DIY shops?
Yes.
Why don't you use his?
Lightwater is the place you go.
Is it?
Oh, right. Yeah. Yes. For the bulb that's gone on the cooker.
Yeah. Right, OK.
The little things like that.
OK, we really want to understand what you genuinely think are DIY jobs at home.
okay? The British are a nation who do it themselves, and 3 out of 4 people will regularly dip into their toolbox.
Who is prepared to paint a wall and would see that as a DIY thing?
If we can work out exactly which jobs they do, then we can start to focus Tony's stock.
Can I just have the people who think yes on the yes side and the no's on the no side? Yeah, that's most of you would have a go at painting the wall. Paint woodwork. Woodwork all over, have a go at woodwork. Right, so okay.
Put up shelves.
There are some tasks people feel are beyond them.
Plaster a wall. Right, now that's quite telling, isn't it? So
fix a dripping tap.
Oh, Christ.
But there's a lot of small jobs people are willing to do.
Unblock a toilet.
Unblock a toilet.
Unblock a toilet.
I have done that.
Change a fuse.
Which gives us the steer we need.
Thank you. Thank you for that, and thank you for your feedback and for being so honest, especially the people on the no side.
So did you get a sense of what you think the top 10 DIY jobs are?
Yes, I think so, yes.
Yeah. I'm going to have a look at mine and think about it.
Yes.
You look at yours. And I think that will really give you a kind of clear idea of what you should be buying, but also how we lay that shop out so this consumer knows that you really understand and own those different areas instead of this general store. Yeah, we got a lot of fixing to do, Tony.
We have.
A lot.
Yes.
So now, Tony and I need to tell his crew our plan.
OK, right, let's start off. I know you think this is all kind of cute and together. It's not. It's a mess in here. I come in here and I can't see anything, and I want the shop segmented into simple areas. OK, put everything together. Plumbing, all plumbing stuff together. Electrical, tools and hardware. Decorating, gardening, OK, those are your key areas. Would you agree that that will help you?
Mm-hmm. It would help.
Yeah. OK, we need to condense and we need to get rid of lines that aren't working. So let's try this. Will you give it a try for me?
Yeah.
But reorganising this store isn't enough to fix Tony's troubles.
The biggest problem facing this business, as we know, are the massive big chains, the warehouse chains. We've got customers who go directly there to buy their DIY goods, and they are bypassing your shop. Now, please tell me why they should come here. I want a good reason from every single one of you. Jane, if I'm a customer, why should I come here and not to the big warehouses?
So we're nice and friendly.
Right, that's very helpful, but I could get that from the cafe.
Local, you don't have to travel, to a big warehouse.
Okay.
Experience, knowledge.
Good one.
The advice?
Advice.
The advice that comes with it?
What every one of you has said is local, knowledge and service. OK? And I agree. Although I'm not sure how much knowledge and service we really are giving. OK? And I love the fact that you're happy and friendly, Jane. But I also want you to know what you're telling me. I want to rely on you. I want to trust you. So in order to do that, you need training up. And that's what we need to look at. If we are going to differentiate and we are going to make more money, we all need to have the knowledge.
Jane's husband has already tried to get her into DIY.
Clyde brought me a purple toolkit for Christmas. That's my favourite colour. He used to have purple hair. So I used to... Oh, don't bloody laugh at me, Jane.
So you had purple hair like that and a purple toolkit. Pleasure. What else do you like?
Handbags.
How many have you got?
About 240. You've even got matching purses to go with them.
Where'd you go with all those handbags, Jane?
I don't, only you.
Tony's taken on staff whose passions and experience are definitely not DIY, and he's failed to train them up. It's no surprise people only come here for rabbits and light bulbs.
If I can get these guys trained up and knowledgeable in DIY, then we might have a chance. Also gives them something else, you know? Staff want to be motivated, they want to be incentivised, and they want to learn. And you start to build up a team of people who become experienced. That's how you maintain staff. And on the back of it, you can make more money.
But what I believe isn't enough to convince Tony.
It's just not as easy as you're saying it is. I don't think it's as easy as you're saying it is. I'm in board with it, we'll do it. But I'm just saying, it's not as easy as she thinks it is. I don't think it is.
It's absolutely essential that novices on the team like Jane understand and even like DIY. What London Fashion Week is for clothes, the totally DIY trade fair is for tools.
Have a nice journey up.
Yes. With 150 stands showing around 4,000 tools, even I'm inspired to put up a shelf. Jane's education starts here.
So I'm here today to tell you about the handy pad. Now, we can distribute anywhere in the world, obviously.
Why do you think I'm getting you here?
Your presentation, you know what you're doing, you know what you're talking about.
Knowing what you're talking about, absolutely spot on. When you go in and you buy your handbag, the person knows about handbags, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you've got to be the same about your tools, because later on you're going to be selling to me and about 10, 20 other people around the corner, right?
Yeah.
As passionate about your product as you are about your handbags, OK?
Demonstrating what you sell and how to use it should be commonplace in Tony's shop, so I've arranged for Jane to have a go. She'd better get up to speed with the tools she'll have to promote.
Best one-handed clamp on the marketplace. So if you wanted to clamp it up here quite quickly, you drop it down, two squeezes to the hand, and if you feel that, you can't take it any further, 250 kgs of pressure. Quick release button.
Before she sells it for real, there's a quick chance for some practice.
I've put the clamp on the
workbench.
On the workbench.
Yeah.
And then I'll press the release button.
Hang on, what weight could it take?
250 whatever.
Kilos.
Kilos. Yeah. And now I've got a do that.
Would you buy this?
What, after seeing this? I need a bit more convincing, I think.
But after a little more coaching,
keep using all the moving parts, because the moving parts show everybody how easy it is to use.
And even a quick masterclass from Tony.
So you've got 250 kgs of pressure there. That'll hold everything.
Very good.
It could also be used as a spreader. You take the end off, just reverse it round.
He has got the knack. Go, Tony.
Capable of holding any frames or drawers or cabinets apart like that.
Not bad. We bought that,
yeah,
wouldn't we?
Yeah, we'd have a go with that.
It's time for Jane to face the public.
If you can do this and sell to all the people that are sitting there, let me tell you, when someone comes into your shop, it's going to be a piece of cake.
I hope you found the right tool for the right job, but I haven't yet seen your face.
All I've got to do is get up there and do what I have to do and then I'm done, am I? Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I have got a quick grip in my hand here, the strongest one on the market. It will hold 250 kg, two clicks, and it will not move now. And I've got a silver handle here which releases it, so you can take it off.
It's not easy. I hate doing stuff like that. Standing up in front of someone and doing a demonstration on a product that you've had in your hand for half an hour.
And that is called a spreader. You can use it for drawers, you can use it for picture frames, door frames. Retail price is about £25. I would have never in my dreams done what I did today. So I did enjoy it.
Whilst this has been fun, I also hope it's helping to shift Jane's whole attitude to DIY and her products.
Right, OK. Think about the business. The team get trained up. They don't need to be builders, decorators, but they have a knowledge of product and a knowledge of DIY. And you start to get a really nice kind of business model that I think will be very different from what the chains are doing and much more personal.
Yeah. You're right, I maybe should show them more things than I do.
I love that. That was brilliant. I loved sitting there watching you. But that's nerve-wracking, though, doing that.
Yeah, it is.
Anyone, isn't it?
Yeah.
Jane, as you saw, she got the confidence because she knew what she was selling or had explained to her what she was selling. And that's what we've got to do. And they'll all do that. I'm sure they will. OK. So it's good fun, then, yeah?
I did enjoy that. I didn't think I'd be able to do anything like that.
No, I told you, it'd be good.
But as well as tackling his staff and his shop, I think we've got to look outside of the store if we're to compete with the warehouse rivals. We know people are willing to take on small tasks, but my homework says a third of us start DIY jobs that we don't finish. I have a feeling a local hardware store could be of help, so I'm taking Tony door knocking.
I just want to see whether there's a kind of a new business opportunity that goes outside just the confines of the shop. Because the shop, you're there waiting for people to come.
Yes, yeah.
Whereas if you proactively get out, there might be some business, and I just want to see.
Yeah, fine.
Have you ever done this? Have you ever
no.
been?
No.
No.
Hello.
Mary.
Hi, Mary. Come
Tony.
In. Tony. Hi, Tony.
Hi.
Come
Can
in.
We come in. What sort of DIY jobs do you have that you need round the house? I mean, is there stuff that you think, oh, God, I haven't got round to doing that?
As you came in the front door, there's a door to the garage and it needs architrave round it and the skirting board needs finishing in the porch.
So what is that up there talking about? That's one of those that you put on an arm or whatever that's been cut. Is that a bandage? Right, so there's another job. Honestly, that is just hysterical.
That's another job that hasn't got sorted is... bathwater coming through.
It's not a big job.
No?
Pull this off here and just plash it over.
There must be hundreds of jobs out there just waiting for the right advice and the right tools. And I am sure there's a great business opportunity here.
Two services that Tony could do. He could say, OK, we'll come round, we'll make a list of what you need for that job, that job, that job, and we'll deliver the goods for you. Is that something that would interest you?
Yes, it would.
Yeah.
Just one delivery to a home like this could be worth at least £30 or £40, a lot more than the £5 people usually spend in Tony's store.
No, it's quite interesting.
Imagine if you went round with a list and said, right, OK, we'll have that to you by Friday. There is a potential.
Mm.
Right, on to the next one. Let's find out who else is out there. Tony, this one's over to you.
We had a slight accident there. I mean, it's been well over a year now. And,
You know, if someone showed you how to do it, you could do it. It's quite easy, and cost-wise, it's not very expensive.
Mm. That's a silly little thing there.
So what's the list of stuff? What would that be? Adhesive,
a bit of filler, bit of wood filler, and a varnish for the top.
OK. That?
Small pieces of ply that go above the ceiling, and then plaster the holes this side.
If Tony can create a service that gets into people's homes, we can stop them before they even think of going to the superstore rivals.
I love the idea of a house check, you know, a house health check. All those little jobs. I've done two houses in about half an hour. I want to see how many he could possibly get because I believe it's got the potential.
So I'm going to leave Tony to persuade 50 households to agree to a home fix, check-up and delivery. Days later, I'm back. As well as pushing on with the home fix service, I'd asked Tony to focus his stock and reorganise his shop. So I can't wait to see where he's got to.
I'm hoping that they've picked up on all the key things I left them to do. Segment that shop clearly, with signage and to end use. So as I left it electrical, gardening, carpentry, I want to see that as a shopper so they're not spending half their time running around the shop. And lastly, all the names for them doing the house calls. I've asked them to get 50 names and I'm hoping they've got that, or even more. Morning, ladies.
Hello.
You all right?
Yes, you?
Yeah. Where's Jane? Is she around?
Jane, she's up in the haberdashery.
Jane! Come here!
Oh, I'm too tired. You're on your way up here.
Redoing her haberdashery.
What do you mean you're too tired?
No, I'm knackered this morning.
Right, okay.
I am. I'm no good to no one today.
Did you just get a tattoo done? What is that on your face? What is it?
I just had a tattoo done.
What are you like?
I'm no good to no one today.
Well, you're going to have to be. What have you done? What have you both done since I was last here to show how you've really put all your product together? Has anything changed?
I'm moving about now.
Don't be silly. You're putting a few old needles on the back.
Oh, no, really, they're not needles. They're buttons.
This is a mess. Don't you think this is a mess? If you're a customer, do you not find this confusing? You two?
No, not really.
All you've done is had a few tattoos, so get back and put your needles back out.
This is pathetic. And the buck stops with Tony.
I've just been round the shop floor. You know, when I left, I went through a couple of key things I wanted doing. One was to segment the shop floor more clearly and try and make it more user-friendly. Remember I talked to you about that?
Whatever you move, you've got to move something else first, obviously. There isn't enough room.
But that's because you've got a lot of stuff in there that I just don't think should be in there. And
like
I was
what?
Hoping, oh, my God, like some of that household stuff, you know, that is just absolutely hopeless.
Well,
all that shoes and the kitchen.
Well, we sold a pair of those slippers you said weren't that good. Well, we don't sell. We sold them last week, or week before. When it
one
was.
Pair?
Yeah, I know. I'm just saying.
The big problem is people aren't coming to you for their big DIY buys, right? They're not coming to you for that. They're coming to you for the small items. I might run out of some cling film. I'll pop down to Tony's, but that is not a business. It's not a business, Tony. And that's why I wanted you to look at the training of the staff and building the client base outside by going to those homes. How did you get on with the door ones, the 50 names that I wanted?
Well, I didn't get any. I asked two or three people who came in. one was interested, and the other two had, yes, we got something. One was electrical type work.
So you didn't go out to any of the shops?
No.
Why, Tony?
I haven't got time.
Why making the time? Why?
Because I haven't got... I'm trying to run this business. I haven't got time to do other things as well.
Because you haven't got time running the business that isn't making you money at the moment. And I'm trying to give you an absolute business idea that will make you money, and you've just jettisoned both of them.
I'm not a salesman. I can't go around knocking on doors.
You are a salesman, Tony.
No.
That's what this business is, mate.
Yep, no. Right.
I'm just going to go and have a coffee and a sit down. And then I'll come back and I'll go through what I think will be done with the business. And you might say to me, disagree, and I'll go tatty bye. Or I do agree, and how do we make this work? And I'll work it out with you.
Fine.
Is that fair enough?
Yeah. Okay. We'll do that. Well, I don't think she's quite... sees from my point of view, but she can't expect us to jump straight away because it's not that sort of business.
So 3 weeks relaunch and I'm no nearer anywhere. I've not done anything with them. I'm absolutely gobsmacked that nothing's been done. Nothing. Not just one or a little bit. Nothing. Nothing. What I'm trying to do is give him a business model that is ownership of a DIY market. Fact, we know that that market's growing. Fact, we know that people are spending more on their home. Fact, we know that they're doing it themselves to save money in a really tough climate. Fact is, you've got a business that could do that, Tony. Fact is, you're not up for it, mate. He is just nodding at me and then blindly ignoring everything I say. Well, how am I going to do this business? What's going to happen? This is going to be impossible if Tony carries on like this. So I've called time out to find out why he is so apathetic about his own business. Do you care enough? I need to know from you, do you really care enough that you are going to make significant changes in that business?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Why don't you think that?
Because I keep questioning, where's your energy? Where's your passion? Where's this man's energy to make this change? And we've got a big job to do. I mean, I don't think it's easy. We have a big job to do here.
I don't know what it is. Well, lose your passion. Maybe you do lose your passion. I used to be quite passionate about it.
Well, you must have been, because you were very successful. You had a very successful business in the 80s. Mm-hmm. Someone told me you were a polo player.
Yeah.
Well, you don't do that with Thrupp's Halfpenny, do you?
No.
A bit of pocket money. Did you feel a bit lost now?
It's a big... a big come down sort of thing.
Yeah.
Gets to you in the end, doesn't it, I suppose? And you had the good life and blew it, as they say. For nobody else's fault but your own, which makes it even worse. You can't blame anybody else. But there we are.
So, should we try and get the good life back?
Yeah.
No, not as bad as that. I'm not having you out 24/7 and doing your polo world. I think he's quite a nice guy, you know. I like the guy. But, you know, I think he's been damaged. And somehow I've got to give him a sense of purpose back and a confidence back alongside giving him a vision, which is a big thing. It's a big thing. It's every aspect of this business. It is a big ask, but I hope we can now move forward with renewed energy. My plan is to try and make this shop idiot-proof. DIY and even the big superstores can seem very intimidating, so the local DIY shop should be the opposite,
My team have designed a store that will be fun and accessible to all. Peter, my business partner, is taking Tony through my plans, which start with a brand new name.
The name that Mary's given your business is The Fix-It Factory. And it's just a one-stop place for your home and for all your trade needs. Mary's really confident that will make a very powerful statement about your new business.
I'm for that. That bit you're OK with.
That bit we like, yeah? OK?
Yeah.
Shopping's all about inspiring people, and this Fix-It Factory needs to do that, as well as having a really logical, navigated experience for the shopper. So we're going to put in place a very simple process of navigation, which is about colour-coding the departments. Right. So as you're moving around the shop, you've got different colours
and very clear levels. That is exciting.
And it's connected to the business,
that is.
And finally, I'm kicking out that crazy card shop. It's going to become a new decorating area and the hub for customer service.
The only way we think to physically do this is to literally close the doors for a couple of days.
Right. That's going to be very, very difficult. Mm. My main crux is I don't want to disappoint the customers that come from a long way away to us.
Yeah. We need this area clear because we won't do it. You know, there's no way the shop's going to reopen on the opening day unless that area is clear. So I don't know how yet, but we need to find some way of allowing you to sell in those 2 days, but it can't be in that area.
Right.
We're on?
That'll work. Yep. We're there. We're there. I like everything we're going to do. I think it will make us a nice, clean, fresh image that hopefully will increase business, make us more professional, and make us more what the public want us to be.
It's great that Tony seems to be embracing the new changes to his shop, because today I want them to think about my world of retail, and I know Tony's pretty suspicious of that. I think DIY superstores are missing a trick. Selling even functional items should be fabulous. Just because Tony is selling plungers, it doesn't mean they can't be shown off in a fun and attention-grabbing way. So I've invited the Lightwater crew to a surprising venue to show them what I mean.
Have you been to the Saatchi Gallery before, guys?
No, I haven't, no.
Why do you think I've brought you here?
Because it's made out of household.
No idea.
You got no idea, Tony?
No idea.
It's made out of bulbs and house electrical stuff.
It's all the stuff that you would sell, yet they've made a piece of art out of that. Would you ever look at your product like that?
No.
No.
Do you like looking at it like that, though?
Yeah, it's good. It's good. It's different.
Why should we not have fun? Because the product is functional product.
That's what you mean.
You know? It's called being and buying. And if you want to be in a space and you create spaces that customers enjoy being in, then it's a given they will buy. I'm really glad that you guys are inspired by that.
The exhibition is centred on a range of modern sculptures by Indian artists.
Weird.
Yeah, weird. I've never been to a gallery, so this is the first time. It's good.
Oh, oh. And I just love the idea that we could do that with product.
It makes people stop, doesn't it?
I like it. I think it's different. Yeah, it's different,
It's good.
Oh, that's
wicked, that is.
Isn't that great?
That is amazing. Is that like kitchen utensils?
That's like kitchen utensils.
I love it. Make a good feature in the shop, wouldn't it? Just in the middle. Take one of those stands down and just leave it in the middle. You could lose one of your stands, couldn't you?
Yeah.
Rob, Tony said yes to losing one of his stands.
Kitchen utensil.
Yeah, department.
Yeah. Yeah.
Being here inspires me to just take some of it back to the shop, whether it's to do with the colours, brightening it up, making use of what we've got. Definitely want to do something with kitchen utensils.
If I'm honest, I thought they won't get this. I'm a little bit embarrassed that I thought they wouldn't, but they got it instantly. And not only that, it's the most inspired they've been since I stepped foot in that shop. Now, those little Indian pots, stunning, stunning.
No, I'm surprised to end up at a gallery, but I do see what she's trying to say. Not quite sure how I'm going to translate into the shop, though.
Well, Tony's about to find out. I want the team to have a go themselves, using some of the products they sell in the shop. So I'm taking them to an artist studio in East London.
Here's a lovely space. This is Elsa.
Hi. Lovely to meet you.
Elsa Tierney's installations have graced cutting-edge fashion shops. I want her to help them produce their own displays and bring some creativity back to Lightwater.
We've got a Blue Peter afternoon for the team. I want you to take those products and create a visual display with them. It's going to be fun. Forget about selling. It will sell itself if you get the visual display right. This is fun.
This is great. So much along the Warhol, and I think Jane's work could maybe go along more minimalist.
This is like going back to my days at art college. This is what everybody did, and I took that into Windows, and it's just really weird. I can't resist grabbing hold of it.
I was hoping someone would show some natural talent, and no one is proving more inspired than Jamie.
You made that.
I do like paintbrushes. The spiral effect. I tried to get the straight effect, and I got the spiral.
How much are you going to sell that one for?
That's worth loads, that is.
I think it's terrific. I really do.
But Tony is giving her a run for her money.
If I had something, a cloth or leathers or something like that, you know, that would have been better coming.
Yeah, I mean, I actually have to say that touch with the glove pointing at the light bulbs is just fun and clever.
Yeah, it's very fun.
Always happens to me, always.
Yeah. Maybe you won't be in charge of display in the shop then.
No.
Class over! I actually thought everybody was superb. I'd love you to be doing this for the windows. But the customers go by and they just go, that just makes me happy. That's a place that actually loves its stuff. Do you see the difference?
Yeah, definitely. It's what you need, yeah. You need to display the stuff and...
So will you take that responsibility, yeah. Jamie? Yeah?
Yeah.
We have got the window space on one side.
You've got it, totally.
It does hit you there as well, because it's a nice big window. I feel excited and positive. I think the penny's finally dropping what we're trying to do, or what Mary's trying to do.
I can see how that shop will feel. I can see how it will feel. And I feel more positive now because I know that they will do that with me. And today, for the first time, I think they genuinely loved the product that they're working with. It's good, isn't it? It's good.
Back at the store, they've begun streamlining the stock.
Yeah, okay.
Don't even ask me why fishing is next to curtains. I have no idea.
But reorganising a shop that's 3,000 square feet is a mammoth task, and we've only a few days until the relaunch. So to speed things up, I've sent in one of my team, Elpida.
So not necessarily in the power tools section.
Yeah, not necessarily.
Time to say goodbye to the fluffy animals.
Aww.
And the crazy party shop.
Oh, it's upsetting that it's going, but we didn't sell that many toys. I think it will be a good thing.
The staff might be on board, but after 12 years without changing his business...
One double stock, I'm talking about...
On the right-hand wall.
Accessories.
No, on the right-hand wall.
OK.
Tony's having a bit of a meltdown.
We've got no 15-inch shelving. Without taking it off there, that's 12, so I want 3 inches. I haven't got 3 inches. You can't move one thing from A to B because you've got to move B. But to move B, you've got to put it somewhere, so you've got to move C. To move C, you've got to move D. We haven't got any empty space at all. The departments, what we've got them set at, is the departments. We cannot expand the department. We've got to put other things in it because there's already something there. Does that make sense?
And he's starting to backtrack over my other ideas as well.
To put a display in the window, I don't honestly believe you're going to gain anything out of it. And also, the name of the shop, the Fixer Factory, we're a village in Lightwater, not an industrial estate somewhere, you know, like Screwfix, you know, that's what it's going to relate to. The more I thought about it, and I've been mentioning it to people, customers as well, bad idea. This will not work.
So, just days away from the relaunch, I'm heading back in to battle again.
I've had a few phone calls from my design team and shop fitting team saying that some of the things that we agreed with Tony, he's not wanting to do now. So I'm going to go down, take a look and find out what the hell's happening.
No,
oh. breathing space. This looks better. Hi, old Peter.
Hi.
That looks great, the tool shop, doesn't it?
Well, you've got it there.
And it looks good.
It's fantastic. What do you think it is, Tony?
It's not big enough. I haven't got all the stock on it.
Don't you think that looks 10 times better?
No.
I actually look at this and think that is just 100% better. It looks neat, it looks tidy, it looks together, and we've got a few extra tools on that side. I don't know why you're so upset about it, Tony.
It's just not up to what we normally have, you see, that's all I'm saying. The stands, they look cheap stands.
Oh, give me... You're not telling me that's not up to what we had here before?
Anyway, you know, it's done now, so it's done, isn't it?
Should we have a walk around? What else? Let's show me the rest, come on.
Okay, so we've,
That looks much better. Jeez, it's a massive job. I mean, I don't think you need much of this stuff. I really, really don't. I mean, some of this is just bin it stuff, you know, if I'm honest.
Why is that?
Because I told you before, I don't want to come in here for this.
But we sell it.
But you sell anything. Eventually you sell anything, but you're not master of the DIY. Eventually you sell anything.
We're not a DIY shop, are we? We're not purely a DIY shop.
But I thought that's what we wanted it to be.
Yeah, but it's not purely a DIY shop as it stands at the moment, is it?
As it stands at the moment. So this is stuff that we should be getting rid of, you know? But you don't agree with me, really.
No, I don't. Okay. I don't.
Well, that's fantastic because I've got a day to go. I hear that you don't want to do the window, because that's going to be maintaining, far too difficult to maintain.
No, I didn't say that.
You didn't? Right, so I'm having a window. Okay, but I want the window, right? And I hear you don't want to call it the Fix-It Factory.
It's only because I've talked to people about it, and their reaction isn't very positive, really.
What is
this? They said, it, you know, it's not a factory, you know, you're not a factory, which we're not a factory.
Oh, my God.
We're in like...
They all sound like a literal bunch of half-wits. I wouldn't listen to, you know? Oh, you're not a factory. Let me think.
I understand the opposite of the factory, you see.
Café de Paris. It's not in Paris. They better change the name on that in the West End of London. I mean, look, that's literal rubbish. Do you want the name or not?
I'll give it a try. I'll give everything a try. I told you I would.
The truth is, I know. He's moaned about everything behind my back. I know it. I've had all my team here, I know it. I'll probably go away and he'll get the Tippex out and take out the Fix-It Factory and put Lightwater Homecare. That might happen, but you know what? I am not going to lose sleep over it because I've done my best and I've done what I genuinely, genuinely think is the right thing for this business. Take it or leave it.
I don't know, maybe it's a love-hate relationship, you know. I don't know. She loves her and I love me and we hate each other, so it might be that way.
With Tony begrudgingly agreeing to most of my changes, there's one final thing I'd like to do. I think Tony's team are the best thing about this shop and their service needs to be centre stage. So today I've asked them to my offices in central London because I've decided to turn them into Tony's new brand.
I am going to put you in your new uniforms and I'm going to photograph you all and put you into that store so they always know who you are, right? Yeah. You as well, Tony. Right, you ready for it, guys? Come on through. Right.
Oh, no, I can't.
What do you
look like tango woman in orange.
That's all right, we'll get you to look lovely. Now, listen, this is what you're going to be wearing. You guys are there to help, and you'll be noticed. Stop moaning. A little dance like better than you do half the time. And then you can put your handbag on with it when you're going out in the evening, OK?
At least they'll be able to see who's serving and who's a customer.
You've got to wear one as well, Tony.
Sorry?
You've got to wear one as well.
Yeah, I know, yeah.
Right. Right, come on!
Green.
Yeah, it looks great. And just that graphicness of the colour. And that's great, great. Love the angle. Good one. Lower it down. Yeah, go, Jamie. Great stuff, right? So nice. Smile. No, your perfect pose. Here to help. Come on. That's it. Get it, right? There we go.
I hate smiling.
Get her to work those legs in the morning. I know when you walked in you thought that the orange was going to make you look like the tango woman, and believe me, it doesn't. But
I'm sure you can see this, that the power of this together says we're a team, that you're part of this business, you know, and you're all trained up and you know about DIY. That's why people will come back time and time again. So please, wear it with pride. Don't forget your badges, OK? So are we happy and proud to be wearing them on the launch day?
Yes.
We've got a bit of work to do, haven't we, to get that shop ready, right?
I will wear them. I will. Because people are notice us, people have come up to us in the shop and that, because it's something different.
Well, I'm happy with it. Happy with the name badge as well?
We'll be able to have... The new people that are going to come into the shop, they're going to need to know our names and that, aren't they? Yeah.
After 6 weeks, we are ready to relaunch the Fix-It factory. So I'm headed to the shop for the official opening in a couple of hours' time.
I'm hoping that I'm turning up to the shop today and I'm seeing a different feel shop. This was like a massive job. You know, this big old warehouse that I had to deal with has been a massive task. But I'm hoping that there's an energy with the staff, most of all, that they understand what the vision is and that they're going to be part of it. I think I've done the job that I came here to do, but I don't think it's been fulfilled with Tony genuinely believing in this vision and giving the time to it.
I'm hoping that new design does bring more customers in, obviously, and a new layout of the place. Let's hope it does.
That feels so much better already.
This clean, bright Fix-It factory shopfront is a world away from the previous drab, off-putting exterior. The wacky card and toy shop has become the decorating store, and the sprawling, confused mess inside is now logically laid out, clearly signed and customer-friendly.
Hi! Morning!
Good morning.
How could you, what do you think?
Perfect.
Doesn't it feel good?
Yeah, it does good.
No, but can you feel this and look down there and think this feels like a proper, great DIY shop?
And somebody's also created an artistic product display.
How to put up a shelf. Who did that? Is that you?
Me and Holly. Yeah.
Did you? Yeah. Come here and talk me through it. I love it.
I knew exactly what to do, but I just had a bit of trouble writing it down.
Fantastic! Oh, isn't that great? So, when anybody comes in and they're looking for stuff, for some shelving stuff, or want some brackets, you're able to go, have you got all these bits? No, aren't you?
Yep.
Good morning, Tony.
Good morning.
Looks great, doesn't it?
We're getting there. I think we're almost there.
It looks great. I love their little display area, the how-to.
Yes.
And that is important. It's great. And that becomes a promotional site for you as well. So when it's seasonal, you know, how to do your barbecue. Or, you know, it can be anything. How to make Tony happy. That'd be a funny one, wouldn't it?
He's smiling.
He is this morning. Oh. I'm really excited.
The results of the photo shoot are back from the printers.
Let me see who's behind.
These shots deserve to be pride of place.
It's a bit embarrassing having our picture in the window, though.
I thought we might have had pictures inside the shop of ourselves, but not in the window.
And it's time for us to get into our new uniforms.
Right. We're nearly there.
Sadly, Tony never did pursue the vital home fix delivery service, but his team have made a real effort with the window displays.
The windows are fun. You know, everything just looks fun and inviting now. All of them have started to get involved in the business as opposed to being passive. And I like that. Then they feel that they're part of the thing.
After a few last-minute touches to the shop, we're pretty much ready for the relaunch.
Basically, when customers come in, I want you to talk to them about the home fix, OK? Don't know your DIY, we're here to help you. It's a new offer, and that's the way DIY is going to be. All right, guys? Tony, open the door. Tony, come in.
Who's going to be first? Someone's got to be first.
Good morning, everybody. Don't queue up as it's cold enough.
Well, it smells lovely. It looks
Yeah, it's much better with it all being
signposted, you know, what you want.
It was always a cavern, you know, where go way back. And it looks light and bright, and I think people will find it very easy to find everything they want.
Do you want to, any of you want to come through next door? Yeah. Do you want to go to the new playroom? No, it was no good.
I always.
What colour have you got yours?
Well, at the moment, we've got orange in our bedroom. We've got yellow and orange.
Even if Tony hasn't been signing up the home fix deliveries, his team are making headway.
We go round with you in your house and you can name all the bits and bobs that you need doing.
Right.
And then we write down the materials that we need. Right. Once we've sorted all that out, we deliver it to your door.
That's wonderful, yes.
Would you like to sign up today?
Yeah, I love it.
When I first met Jane, she was really like a shrinking little violet behind the counter. And look at her today. She's running it.
Was there anything that any of you needed? Have you looked out in the shop?
Yes. It looks very nicely labelled everywhere.
Before, I didn't know anything. I was just a cashier. I just worked behind the till. But now I'm able to get out and say, hey, customer, I know what I'm talking about now. So take notice of me. And I will try. I will try my hardest.
And even Tony's selling.
You strip them?
You can rub it down. You
can paint on the top, and that's the best way to do it.
This shop was a huge task, but it was made all the more difficult having to fight Tony every step of the way.
Some of the ideas, on the face of it, they're good ideas, but I do need a bit of time to think about it. I'm not very good at being spontaneous. Maybe it's just me nowadays. I do get stressed at the drop of a hat. Maybe that's what it was. But it was. I do see the good side of it, and I do see the fun side of it. And I'm pleased that I did it. I think.
Good luck, Fix It Factory. You deserve it, all right? Remember, service, service, service. Right, here's a customer. Terrific.
Come in.
Come in.
Hello.
Hello. Done. My first DIY business, done. It's a happy business and it's very simple. It's a very, very, very simple business model. We will fix it. You know, one-stop fix it. That's what people want to know. This isn't the end. This is just the start. There it is. Now it's up to you, Tony. Whether he's able to do it, I actually still don't know today. So maybe I've got the wrong person with the right business.
It alone, surprisingly, Tony has started my home fix delivery concept.
We've done about 30 visits, and out of that, I think we got about 15 when we actually delivered something. So we had a £70, £60 one, £65 one. That's the biggest one so far.
But some of the other changes have already been reversed. The greeting cards have snuck into the back of the store and a Lightwater Homecare sign has gone up alongside my Fix It Factory logo.
I put the sign back up last week because I get a lot of people coming and asking, is it the same shop and is it the same people here, sort of thing.
Thank you.
It's just changes and some people just don't like changes.
But Jane and the rest of the team have taken a different view.
There you go. He's got to give it time. He's got to give it time for people to realise we've got a new name, the Fix It Factory. So we need to push Tony. And we do. We do get our own way in the end.
You can get it if you really want.
Heard the one about the...